Okay, today I'm making a Hungarian traditional goulash from Hungary. And first I put 3 tablespoons of oil and put the flame on high heat and let it heat up and put the meat in there. The meat is previously washed and cleaned. I let that braise for a couple of minutes, maybe 2-3 minutes, till the color is, the meat color will change, like a brownish color. You need to stir it occasionally. The meat needs to be evenly colored. Each piece needs to be the same color, like a light brown. Remove the pot from the flame and remove the meat from the pot. Put it aside. Put back to the flame and lower the flame to medium. And add the chopped, the diced onion, 2 onions, medium size of onion, and let us saute the onion till it's golden brown. You have to saute it till it's golden brown. The oil and the meat dripping mixed up together and they give a very good flavor to the goulash. The goulash is the traditional Hungarian dish, and usually people who live out of town, the farmers and it's a farmer's food. That's what they usually used to eat on Sunday meal. People get together and that's what they eat. And they used to cook it outside with a big kettle, and they invite the whole family, the whole town, and they enjoy the goulash. And it's a Hungarian dish, okay? And now the onion is almost sauteed. I'm adding the garlic in, about 4 or 5 cloves of chopped garlic. And I stir it and let it saute it another 2-3 minutes. I'm adding 2 tablespoons of paprika. If you could get Hungarian paprika, would be good, nicer the color. If not, you could use any paprika. And I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon. You need to stir it between, and adding 1/2 teaspoon of Hungarian hot pepper, because that gives a flavor, and the goulash is good when it's a little bit spicy. And now I'm putting the meat back. Put the carrots, because the carrots need a longer cooking than any other vegetables. So the meat and the carrots should cook a little bit longer, saute a little bit longer, and then I put rest of the vegetable in there. And I'm putting in a pepper. A teaspoon. Okay, I'm gonna put the tomato in there now. Two tomato. I'm going to cover it for about 5 minutes to let it saute on medium heat. Okay, I let the meat saute with the carrot and onion for 10 minutes, and now I'm adding green pepper because I couldn't find yellow pepper. Then you could add green, yellow, and red. So I'm adding the green pepper, one pepper, green, and two red peppers. And it looks beautiful. The color is nice. I'm gonna add the vegetable broth now, 4 cups of vegetable broth. Now I let it cook for 30 minutes. You need to cover it and just let it cook for 30 minutes. Okay, on medium heat. Okay, I'm adding the potato to the meat. I kept the potato in cold water, shouldn't get brown. And now I'm adding the potato, and you stir it in, and I'm adding the bay leaves. And that's all. And you let it cook for another 45 minutes until the meat is tender. We cook it for another 45 minutes. And you have all the ingredients done now. It's cooked, the meat is soft. And now we could serve it, and we could serve it with noodles. Decorates it some parsley. Okay, so I have some medium wheat noodles, and put it on the. Put gravy because this is the good things. With some parsley. This is Hungarian goulash, and that goes with a Hungarian nut cake and a pepper seed cake. What we're going to show inside. And this is a traditional This is a Hungarian nut cake. It's called Kindle. And then we make it with poppy seed too.